of December, when ages beyond number had run their course in the creation of the world, when God in the beginning created heaven and earth and formed man in his own likeness, when century upon century had passed since the Almighty set his bow in the clouds after the great flood as a sign of covenant and peace, the 21st century since Abraham, our father in the faith, came out of Ur of the Chaldees, in the 13th century, since the people of Israel were led by Moses in the Exodus from Egypt, around the 1,000th year since David was anointed king, in the 65th week of the prophecy of Daniel, the 194th Olympiad, in the year 752 since the foundation of the city of Rome, 42nd year of the reign of Caesar Octavian Augustus, the whole world being at peace. Jesus Christ, eternal God, Son of the eternal Father, desiring to consecrate the world by his most loving presence, was conceived by the Holy Ghost, and when 9 months had passed since his conception, was born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judah, and was made man. The Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to the flesh. Came to build, and and he caused this of all things, would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember in his name the poor, the helpless, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all who know not the Lord Jesus Christ, or who love him not, or who by his sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us upon another shore and in a great life, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in this Lord Jesus, we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself hath taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
The Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all.
Amen.
The first lesson, the angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to the city of Galilee named Nazareth. The virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Be not afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you'll call his name Jesus. He will be great, will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How shall this be, since I have no husband?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be conceived, to be born, will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. And thanks be to God.
Rejoice in the Lord, who has done.
Thank you. angel tells the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
shepherds go to the manger. And in that region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger.
Thanks be to God.
From you shall come a ruler who will govern my people Israel.
Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word that I too may come and worship him. When they heard the king, they went their way. And lo, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. us, and St. John the Divine unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came for testimony, to bear witness to the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness to the light, the true light that enlightens every man, who's coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world knew him not. He came into his own, and his own people received him not. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Full of grace and truth, we have beheld his glory, glory as of the only begotten Son of the Father.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. May he who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly grant you the fold of his inward peace and goodwill, the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.